In September 2018, the USA will host the 8th FEI World Equestrian Games at the Tryon International Equestrian Center in Mill Spring, North Carolina. Held every 4 years in the middle of the Olympic cycle, the Games are one of the biggest events on the global sporting calendar, combining 8 Equestrian World Championship caliber disciplines. During the recent test events for the Games, Equestrian World paid a visit to the venue to check out preparations and to touch base with a man whose vision is becoming a reality. The American tycoon behind the Games has transformed Tryon into one of the world's leading equestrian centres. But with such an undertaking, have there been problems along the way for Mark Bellissimo?
And I wouldn't say it was problems that were said. I think it created a lot of opportunities for us as an organization. And so I believe this was purpose-built for international competitions across many different disciplines. I think what this Tryon 2018 Games did is it accelerated the process. I think we anticipated at some point in time that maybe we could run a 2026 World Equestrian Games or 2022 World Equestrian Games. It wasn't anticipated that it would be the 2018 World Equestrian Games.
During our stay, work halted in some areas while the test events were taking place. But the immense undertaking was clear to see, with the construction of a new main stand and an indoor arena for reining and vaulting well underway. It's hard to believe that this mammoth project is based on drawings made one day by Mark as he sat on a hill overlooking the landscape.
What I sketched out is pretty much what it is today. And I think that's been very interesting, and people have sort of joked that they're not sure what I saw in that earth, because in order to get to where we are right now, we've moved about 4 million cubic yards of earth, which is a massive, massive amount of earth. And it's been a source of challenge during rainy periods, and probably hurt us this winter. We lost about 6 weeks with rain, given that we have this type of clay. It ends up, you end up waiting 5 days for it to dry out.
A development as large as this can have an effect on the local community and the environment, but the organization has support for the Games from the local population, the county, and the state of North Carolina.
Everyone views this as a great opportunity to highlight this area. This was the sort of modern birthplace of American horse sport, in that it was the Olympic training ground for the 56 and 60 Olympics with George Morris and Bert Dinemethy and whatnot. So there's a tremendous amount of history in the area. And I think drawing from that and drawing from a very broad and deep equestrian population, albeit very limited infrastructure at the time, made it easier for people to embrace what we were doing.
We'll have more from Tryon in the months to come as September's FEI World Equestrian Games grow ever closer.